Hey, hope you can hear me. Just get off this. Hey Ding, hope you're well, hope you're having a nice Sunday, January Sunday. It's nice sunny weather in London today. It's very nice, went for a nice walk. Cool, so yeah, I think this is kind of starting as a bit of a regular now. Had a kind of good fun session last Sunday, going through this Ali K track, and I thought Today I would bring up an old tune of mine. It's a track called Fifths. Here we go, this is the track. And came out in 2000. It was for my album. At the time I was signed to Columbia France, so it came out on this album, which is Life Changes. And it was a great time. It was kind of real boom dance music. It was great to be signed in France as well, kind of be part of that. Not that I was part of the Daft Punk scene, but kind of off the back of that French touch sound. And it was a time when I had a studio. I was based down in Strong Room Studios down in Shoreditch. I had a room down there. It was brilliant. I had it for about a year and a half. And I just had this kind of indulgent time making an album. I was helped a lot by Marie, who was my A&R. I used to kind of travel back and forth to Paris, sending her demos, getting her opinion. And she kind of really helped me shape the album together with my manager, Guy, at the time. And this track was the first single. And we had a video made, which is brilliant. So I think I should just actually just play it. I've just got Ableton here. We're going to be going through Ableton. Hey, Ali, nice to see you. No, I had no idea you were down at the Strong Room. Amazing. Yeah, I had it was around 1999, 2000. I had a room down there. It was great, actually. But I remember just being distracted all the time because they had the bar and there were just people coming in and out the whole time. And it was a bit crazy. Anyway. Let's play the track. I might as well play the whole thing. So this was just actually before I play this. So this video was by a guy called I think it's Jean-François Julien, and I'm just going on his website here, and it kind of lists all the things he's done. And yeah, like kind of one of the first things he did, I think, was this video. So let me just stop talking and just play this track. So here we go. Here's the track from the start. Thank you. Cool. So all of that background was all well, it was all filmed on blue screen actually, rather than green screen. I think I've got a picture of it actually somewhere. Let me have a look. I actually went down to the shoot. There we go. So it was all on blue screen. There we go. And there's the kind of dancer, boxer guy at the front. The guy in the denim shirt is Jean-François Julien. The guy, that's my manager. And then that's me looking a bit different there. But yeah, it was pretty, I was pretty amazed actually with the result, what they actually kind of managed to project on the back. I had kind of no idea. So yeah, so that's the video. And before we get into the track, there was also it was one of those classic things where the remix is probably better known than this, than my original version, because Jazzanova did the mix. It's here, it's on this. So let's just have a little listen to that. Here we go. Quick listen. Oops, don't want that. There we go. Wicked remix. I think they really kind of took it somewhere else with this remix. So yeah, I won't play the whole thing, but that, yeah, that came out on their remix compilation as well, so you can check it there. But yeah, I think I've still got some of these lying around actually, so maybe I should run a little remix competition or something. But anyway, how come I've got this track? So at the time, my core studio was an Akai S3000, a Roland JV2080, Fender Rhodes. I had that from kind of my first band, an 88 key stage Fender Rhodes. I had a Wurlitzer as well, and a bunch of keyboards. I had a Korg Monopoly, which I ended up selling, unfortunately. SH-101, which I still got. It's up there in my studio. And yeah, they were the kind of main keyboards. And so for a track like this, pretty much all the tracks on the album, everything, all the kind of samples and generally all the drums and everything would all be in the S3000, Akai S3000. And I was also, I don't know if anyone remembers from that time, but I was also using Mesa software. So I would, it was a way of sort of transferring all my files so I could kind of edit them and rename them and save them as well. So I could actually sort of save them on my computer. Originally, you just sort of save them on a sort of floppy disk. Then I got a zip drive, SCSI zip drive. But with Mesa, you could actually connect your computer via SCSI, and then you could kind of organize your files. So I was going back on how I kind of archived everything. And going back on this, let me just see what I've got. So, yeah, I would always kind of create this folder here. And then I'd have a folder which was like Akai S3000 Mesa, and then all the kind of files here would all be, everything that was in all the programs for the Akai S3000 would all be in this. So in each program would be like a .sp file, and then with all the kind of sounds. So what I was amazed at finding was that actually Kontakt imports these Mesa files. It's amazing. So you can actually kind of you can actually recreate an entire kind of S3000 memory bank, whatever you want to call it, with all the different programs and have them all on a different MIDI channel, which is how it would work from your sequencer. I was using Logic, an early version of Logic at the time, but yeah, that's kind of how it would work. So anyway, so I sort of archived these, and I think it was quite a few years ago, I was thinking about getting a live set together, and I was thinking, okay, well, maybe I should actually, with Ableton, try to kind of piece together the track again out of these samples. and in a way that I could perform it live. And I started the process, and this is kind of what I ended up with. It was a combination of that, and then when we got remixes done, I also created this kind of CD where I bounced out a whole bunch of the sound, you know, the main kind of parts, not as like whole stems, but it's just parts. So this is, let me just see what, yeah, I think they look like this. This is the kind of list of sounds that I had, and this is what they look like. So for example, there's this like mono lead, you probably won't be able to hear that actually, I'll play that in a minute. But so anyway, I started piecing it together, and I think I just gave up because I just was like, oh, this is just too complicated. I was just trying to do it all in scenes in session view so I could like trigger it and I could play it live. And so I kind of gave up on it. And then last year I was asked by Point Blank to make a video on Universal Audio's new Luna software. So I thought, okay, well, maybe I can use this track as a way of kind of demonstrating it, and I can kind of export out all the parts and kind of then put it into Luna and kind of mix it again. Hey, great. But I ended up going for another track in the end, but it was quite good. I thought, well, rather than kind of waste that energy that I'd done, let's kind of have a look at the track now. So I've got it in Ableton, and actually before I do that, what might be quite fun is just to look at the original Logic kind of project. If it will load up, let's have a look. Yeah, it's loading up. So this must have been done in like Logic 4 or 5 or something. So this was the sort of starting point really, before I started kind of putting it into Ableton. Let's just see if this loads up. These days, I love Logic, but I have to say I feel a bit more comfortable working in Ableton Live. Let's see. Probably because it loads up quicker as well. It's probably one of the main reasons. Here we go. Let's keep all these unassigned. There we go. Whew. So I think what the process probably was is that I loaded those samples, the Mesa sample program into Kontakt. Then I exported those Kontakt files and then loaded them into EXS. So anyway, that's kind of what the original project looked like. So let's just quit that now. Don't save. Right, so let's just kind of get into this. What I think the best thing to do is if I just kind of almost build it up how I probably composed the track, although I really can't remember exactly how I did it. So let's just take this off. So this is the first part, and this was done on my Rhodes. And if I just play that now, let's just unmute. Let's just bring up the VMPK. So the whole reason this is called fifths is because I'm playing fifths, basically. And I might as well tell you where this came from. Well, not where it came from, but where the influence was this Herbie Hancock track. The track's called Nobu, and it's on his track Dedication. Let me just play that to you. This is an amazing album. This is him recorded in Japan, live in Japan. It's basically ARP 2600, ARP Odyssey, and a Rhodes. There we go. So I'm a massive Herbie fan. So I think that's kind of where it started and where it ended up as well. So let's just bring that back and go back on here. There we go. So it's maybe not exactly what he was playing. This is kind of quite a familiar pattern. If you think of Pink Panther, So that was the kind of, that was pretty much the theme of the track, and obviously that's where the idea of fifths came from. So I had that, then, in fact, is that actually playing an octave up? Maybe it is. So, I don't know. Anyway, it's a real Rhodes. It's not a sample. And so I had that. And then I also got in a bass player, this guy called Mike Lines. I can't remember who introduced me to him. Mike, if you're out there, I'd love to hook up again. But he came in, and it was probably a bit further down the line. But these were some of his parts, which I just... He kind of basically kind of bolstered that bass. So this is the first bit. So you kind of playing along with that. And then he came up with this beautiful part. Actually, no, along with that as well, there was another part he played, which was this. So he's actually playing the kind of single note and then the fifths as well himself. And I remember then he did some sort of improvisation for the middle section, which was this. And I think he kind of had a chorus pedal or something that he put on it. And when he played that, I was like, okay, I've got a new section here. And then he also came up with this kind of funky bit at the end. So Mike really did add a brilliant, some brilliant elements to that. So then we've got the drums, and this is mainly an 808. It's the Akai 808 program that I had in my Akai sampler. Let me just play a bit of that. Let's just play it on its own. And I remember I had my, I don't know where it is actually at the moment. Maybe it's up here, hold on. Oh dear, stuck. That wasn't the idea. Okay, can't get it. Anyway, it's a Boss SE70, and I remember the hi-hats going through that. So let's just play through these patterns. So pretty simple, really. Not that much going on. And if we play that now with the other stuff. So I'm sure this wasn't how Herbie envisaged it. So not much else really happening. I think that, yeah, that was kind of quite an interesting pattern, I thought, at the time. And then this loop comes in, which is this clap beat, and I'm going to play that solo. So I can't remember where this came from, some sample CD somewhere. So you can see kind of as like most tracks, you know, it's building basically. So it's really just kind of starting with that. Bass comes in, that kind of lower bass, and then the drums. Actually, yeah, the 808 comes out there. Cool, so there's that. And then I got back on the roads and came up with this part here, which is quite a funky part. Let me just have a listen to it. I think I've just got some reverb on it at the moment. Sounds like it's got a kind of a wah. I remember I did have a Crybaby at the time, so it could have been that, it could have been some envelope filter, it might have just been something in Logic, I can't quite remember. But it's just a single part, just keeps going round and round. So there's that, and then there's this part on the roads, which I wish I had my Rhodes set up. I haven't got space for it at the moment. I've still got it. This is my parents' house. But I came up with this part here. Let me just play that on the Rhodes sound. Spread the old VMPK up. Here we go. They're in E minor. It's kind of like playing a B sus 4 over the top. Let's just play it, shall we? Something like that, anyway. Cool. Then I kind of thought, all right, well, I've got a lot of those, you know, the kind of key elements. Let's start getting some more synth action going on. So this was the first one. This is from the JV2080, and it's a preset called Translucent. I did actually look it up recently because I've got the Rode & Cloud JV2080, and it's just one of the presets on that. However, it doesn't sound the same. It's really frustrating. So I want to try to load it. I haven't got the patches as well. I'd love to load it back in. Anyway, this is the part. So I had this kind of coming in at the start. And again, doesn't really deviate from that throughout the track. Then I've got this sound here, which I quite like. Now this is like, I called it reverse echoes. So what I'm gonna do is actually listen to what that sounds like reversed, because it was something that was reversed. So this is it. So I can't remember if that was originally another track, or I then did make a track out of it anyway, of that part. If we just hop over to here, if we go to this, my IOTA album, Selected Ambient Works, you can actually find, it's got the track C Beams, actually kind of uses that part, but I reversed it for this track. I just can't remember which way around it was. Anyway, you can hear that there's a kind of auto pan on it. That would have come from the S3000. Um, So that kind of starts off the whole track. Cool, so what other parts we've got? That's that. Then we got, okay, so these are some samples. What are these? Oops, let's unmute it. Okay, so that's that same sample, but I put it into, I kind of key spanned it. And how did I use it? Ah, well, that's played right up there. Maybe I just don't do that kind of thing anymore these days, but that's... Sounds like a little kind of chirping bird. Oh, and I played it in, like, really low as well, like an octave down. Whoa. Nice. Cool. So what else? More stuff from the JV 2080. Again, I can't remember if I sampled these in. I might have done, or they were just being played live. So that's definitely. In fact, I think I've got the JV 1080 up here. So it's not the 2080. It's the Super JV 1080. Here we go. So here are some of the sounds from that. So it was the rave drum set. There we go, that. I remember there's a track by Wham-Do, he used that. So. Brilliant sounds. Definitely kind of rinsed those at the time. So, what I did, I must have sampled them in. So that's from JV, probably tuned to the right key, E minor. That as well. Yeah, the old Wham-Do. That's beautiful. That comes in at the start. That was something I made from my SH-101. Now these are from, I was watching this sort of, at the time, black and white Godzilla film, and I got these samples. Godzilla 1, Godzilla 2. So let's just have a listen to what those sound like. So that's kind of working with those reverse echoes. And then some more Godzilla girls coming in, which... King of my Crate Castle, that's the one, yep. Cool. So then, yeah, actually, I was using the rave plucked directly from the JV 1080. Here we go, so. And that coincides with this string, which I can't remember where that's from. That might have been from my Korg 01W, actually. Let's just play those two together. What other sounds I've got? Crackle. Where's the crackle from? That was from the JV 2080 as well. Sounds like I kind of pitch bent it up or something. Cool. I actually forgot to mention another synth that I had at the time, or thing I had at the time, but I've still got it. It's up there. It's my Nord Modular. And love the Nord Modular, and I've recently got the editing software for it working. which I'm so chuffed I had to use wine bottler for it. But yeah, I've got this kind of acid bass line. Let's just play it with the beat maybe on its own. I'm kind of vowing that I should get more into the Nord modular and start actually building some patches in it. Then we got this, the monopoly, which I remember just playing in live and then kind of cutting up. Quite distorted. I mean, I've got the plugin, the Korg Monopoly plugin, and I just can't imagine ever getting that kind of sound out of it, to be honest. I think I'm just, can't get past the presets. Something about hardware. Maybe I should get the Behringer one, get back into it. So that's pretty much it. And then we've got the Whirly solo. So this is something I remember putting in right at the end. I had a Whirly, not here, unfortunately. And I remember just putting down a few passes and then editing it. And I also had a space echo. I've still got my space echo. It's up there. Just see if you can see that. There we go. Recently had it serviced as well. Absolutely love it. But I've got the UAD Galaxy here. So if we just listen to what it sounds like on its own. Actually, just listen to it kind of how the Whirly solo sounds. So, oh my God, listen to how much bottom end there is on that. I had a Mackie 32 channel desk, so I must have kind of filtered a lot of that bottom end off. There we go. So there is a bit of distortion on it, but I may well have used Logic kind of overdrive or something on it. So yeah, I mean, could try putting see what this sounds like. No. I'll take the dry wet down. That's pretty good. So what I thought would be quite fun to do, because when I used to play this track live and I remember learning the solo, I just thought, oh, it was so sort of imprinted in the track. I thought, well, if I'm going to play it live, I should recreate the solo. So what I'm going to do is actually going to try playing along. I've just got the Contact Scarby Mark I here. Contact doesn't like closing. Come on, what are you doing? Anyway, while it's doing that, let's just bring up the VMPK. There we go. Cool. So let's just try playing along with this solo. And see how far I get. Let's take this off here. Yeah, there's the vinyl. Still got the vinyl album there, sealed. There we go, with fifths on it. With amazing artwork, by the way, from Piff. He's the guy that did all the artwork for the album. And yeah, you might be able to see that kind of rotating 3D thing is something that he sent me way back in 2000. And I've just sort of put it into Photoshop and done a bit of sort of restoration on it. It's a very early GIF. Cool. So let's try playing along. I'll leave the other one in, but I'll just make it a bit quieter. There we go. Maybe a bit louder than that. Okay, see how far I get. You know what? Before I do that, I'm just gonna mute my mic so I don't get a bit of sidechain on this. Nearly got there. Woo. So yeah, I just need to learn it again, really. And then there's one other sound. Here we go. There's this long little SH-101 sound. Nice one. So, hey Demi, how you doing? Ski Sunday. I know it came to me when I was doing a washing up this week. Yeah, I think I might do a regular one. But look, yeah, I mean that's pretty much the project. And yeah, I was thinking maybe I should do a kind of remix competition or something, or make the parts available and, you know, see what people come up with. It's nice to kind of rejuvenate the track. Just going to say while I'm here, that I've got a Bandcamp page, and you can actually get the album here, Life Changes. There we go, it's here, fifths, the first tune, so check it out. And yeah, I think I'm not sure what I'm gonna do next week. I'm actually working on a new album, so I might actually pull up one of the tracks that I'm working on and have a look, see how that's going. It's quite an electronic album, kind of similar vein to this, really. Load of kind of house tunes, but you know, some a bit more experimental. But yeah, hope you've enjoyed that, and thanks everyone for joining in, getting involved, a little bit of chat action. It's quite good. It's all a bit new to me, this Twitch malarkey, but quite enjoy it. So yeah, thanks everyone. Have a nice Sunday evening.